Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video on Rawtherapee. Rawtherapee, open source software, free software for photo editing. It is a very, very great software. I can advise you to use if you are interested for something open source to improve all your photos. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can work with sharpening adjustment. Use the sharpening in adjustment to increase the level of details. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's just one click. And if you are interested by more, the complete course Rawtherapee is available just on the first link on the description below. In this complete course, you will have everything that you need on Rawtherapee. I will explain everything in details, all the adjustment in details and different trainings on photo. So it's just on the first link on the description below. Let's start with this adjustment. I'm going to select this picture. And first, I'm going to zoom in, zoom in, zoom in. And just go on the right, you can find details adjustment, sharpening, and you have multiple options. And the first thing that you need to understand is the contrast threshold, because where you will apply the contrast. You can zoom at 100%. If you zoom at 100%, you have the possibility to activate this mask, sharpening contrast mask, like this. And thanks to that, if you want to see the mask, you need to activate sharpening here. Let's zoom a little bit on the right. Now you realize that with this contrast threshold, if I apply a radius or a amount, it will apply on all the white parts. So it means almost all my pictures. Here you will increase with the different value on all your pictures, but you can reduce with a contrast threshold. And if I reduce, for example, around 140, I will apply my sharpening adjustment only on the edges, only on some part of my pictures. Sometimes it's a little like sharpen only edges if you change the contrast threshold. So now, after to understand that, deactivate the mask here. And I'm going to show you, I can go on contrast around 20. And you can find two things, amount and radius. Amount is the power of your effect. So I can increase the power of my effect just like that. And take a glance, if you change the contrast threshold like this, you will apply more only on the edges. And the second thing that's important is the radius. With the radius, with what will be the radius, the radius is like the thickness of your effect. So it means on the edges, you will have more thickness if you increase the radius, just like that. And this is why if I increase the radius, I can see on all my edges, these different elements, because it is like to add a thickness on all the edges. After, it depends also where you are going to apply this. It means, as I explained, if you click on a sharpening contrast mask, here you apply on almost everything, but I can decrease, for example, like that. If I just go out, so you can see the difference, contrast threshold, and I can reduce on something more specific with the contrast threshold. So very important in sharpening, understand contrast threshold, radius, and amount. This is the three most important things. After, you can add little blur if you want to smooth your effect. So you can just move on the right the blur radius. Here you have a curve. I can advise you to not really touch to that. So most of the time it's okay. It's just that on the left, you can find the shadows, on the right, the highlights, and it's just where will start your effect, where will start your adjustment. And here you have just a gradient. So it means to start from the shadows, 0%, and here it's 100%. Here it's 0%, 100%. And the curve is just made to have normally the best adjustment, but if you want, you can start and, for example, not to apply the sharpen on the shadows. If you move this, you can start little after the shadows. But definitely I can advise you to not move really this curve normally. It is okay. You can also apply this adjustment only on edges. So in this case, be careful because it depends about your contrast threshold, but you can apply only on edges. Now let's see a second example. I'm going to click here, just come back and go on the right, and let's select this example. If I zoom, you can find inside this pagoda the dragon head here. Let's move a little on the right, and this is the same. If I zoom with, I think I can stay with the zoom around 100%, I can one more time activate my sharpening contrast mask and click on sharpening. So depending of what I choose, I can apply to all my edges or just the main edges. I can reduce, or all my pixels or just a part of pixels. Reduce, depending where I want to apply. The sharpening adjustment will be applied only on the white area. So here you apply where you want, So after, I can click on this area. Here, for example, I work more on the edges and I can select my amount just like that. And I can select my radius also just here. But take a glance, if I decrease the threshold, I will have this render. And it's definitely not really good because I have the feeling to add like a noise on my picture at the same time to increase the details. If I zoom, you can find this one. So I can change little the contrast threshold, like for example around 100. And after I can work with the amount, so intensity of my adjustment, and then the radius, it is like little the thickness. So less thickness and increase the thickness, just like that. Be careful, it's more when you zoom. If you zoom little out, for example like this, and I increase the amount, increase the radius, you won't see too much big difference for a simple reason, you need to zoom more. But if I already zoom at 100%, you can find the difference with the amount, just like this, and with the radius also, just like that. And then I can apply, select my contrast threshold, and I can smooth little bit with the blue radius. When you use the blue radius, if for example you have too much like noise, it looks little like noise, you can apply a blue radius after. So this is how you can increase the details level using sharpening. You need to zoom, you need to work with a sharpening contrast mask, and then apply your adjustment with this different value. So let's stop here. If you like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm Nicolas and I work on this YouTube channel to give different tutorials about graphic design software, 3D modeling, 2D animation, desktop publishing software, a lot of things like this, photo editing, photo montage. I'm also online teachers, and first link on the description below, you have my complete course Rawtherapee. So if you are interested by more in photo editing using Rawtherapee to have something really complete, more than just this tutorial, it is on the first link on the description below. For our next video, see you, ciao.